What's up, everyone? This is Dan, PlayStation24 here, guys, and today we're going to be reading Genesis 28 from the NIV version. And guys, I'm sorry if I mispronounce any names, and I know it's pretty late in America, which is where I am. And guys, let me just go ahead and show you guys this. So, whenever I tell you guys to leave a like, guys, make sure to click this bell, and click this thumbs up, and there should be a subscribe button here, guys, around here. And then when you press the subscribe button, there should be a little bell. Make sure to click that little bell to be notified whenever I post. And, yeah, let's just get to it. Genesis 28. So Isaac called for Jacob and blessed him. Then he commanded him, "Do not marry a Canaanite woman. Go at once to Paddan Aram, to the house of your mother's father, Bethuel. Take a wife for yourself there. From among the daughters of Laban, your mother's brother, may God Almighty bless you and make you fruitful and increase your numbers until you become a community of peoples. May he give you and your descendants the blessing given to Abraham, so that you may take possession of the land where you now reside as a foreigner, the land God gave to Abraham." Then Isaac sent Jacob on his way, and he went to Paddan Aram, to Laban, son of Bethuel, the Araman, the brother of Rebekah, who was the mother of Jacob and Esau. Now Esau learned that Isaac had blessed Jacob, and had sent him to Paddan Aram to take a wife from there, and that when he blessed him, he commanded him, "Do not marry a Canaanite woman," and that Jacob had obeyed his father and mother and had gone to Paddan Aram. Esau then realized how displeasing the Canaanite women were to his father Isaac, so he went to Ishmael and married Mahalalel, the sister of Nebroith, and daughter of Ishmael, son of Abraham, in addition to the wives he already had. Jacob's dream at Bethel. Jacob left Beersheba and set out for Haran. When he reached a certain place, he stopped for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lay down to sleep. He had a dream in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth, with its top reaching to heaven. And the angels of God were ascending and descending to it. There above it stood the Lord, and he said, "I am the Lord, the God of your father, Abraham, and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying. Your descendants will be like the dust of the earth, and you will spread out to the west and the east, and to the east, to the north and to the south. All peoples on earth will be blessed through you and your offspring. I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go. And I'll bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you." When Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, "Surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it." He was afraid and said, "How awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven." Early the next morning, Jacob took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. He called that place Bethel, through the city, to be called Luz. And Jacob made a vow, saying, "If God will be with me and will watch over me on this journey I'm taking, and will give me food to eat and clothes to wear, so that I return safely to my father's household, then the Lord will be my God, and this stone that I've set up as a pillar will be God's house. And of all that you give me, I'll give you a tenth." Thank you guys for watching, guys. I know that was pretty short, and I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to click that little like button, and click the subscribe button also, and click the little bell to be notified whenever I post, guys. Hope you guys enjoy it. And guys, if you guys want to go ahead and read some of the Bible and get ahead of me, you guys can go to this place, Bible Gateway. I'll leave a link in the description. I hope you guys enjoyed. Bye.